Hey guys, what's up? It's Bomb Block, and welcome to my ultimate money making series. And we're starting off with episode 1, Money Through Skills. This guide is actually a remake of the one I made in early 2010, only this time it will be in HD, it will have commentary and the prices will be updated, so enjoy. Here is a list of the skills that can make you at least 100k cash per hour. Obviously most methods and skills can get you a lot more than that, but I wanted to put the bottom line on 100k, and some methods could actually go up to 1 million cash per hour. Before we start, I wanted to put a quick note. Most of the methods I'm showing will make you cash and will also get you XP per hour, but obviously the methods I'm showing aren't the fastest XP per hour, because some boosts can get you more XP per hour, but these will not get you extra cash. For example, urns, fishing gloves and special auras, etc. Also, please note that prices can change every single day, and therefore it's worth checking out the prices before you're actually starting a method or actually spending money on it. Okay, and the first skill is fishing, and I'm going to show you how to fish lobsters. The requirements here for are level 40 fishing and a lobster pod. Cash per hour is about 60 to 100k cash per hour. It totally depends on your level, and that will also make the XP rate per hour 30 to 45k XP per hour. The locations are the Fishing Guild, Ketherby, the free-to-play location Karamja at Musa Point, or Jatizo. It's also optional to bring a fishing familiar, the granite crab, which gives a boost of 1, the ibis, which gives a boost of 2, and the granite lobster, which gives a boost of plus 3 fishing. And this means you'll get faster fish. And for the second fishing method, where fishing is swordfish and tuna, this requires 50 fishing and a harpoon. The cash per hour will be between 70 and 110k per hour, which will make an XP rate of 35k to 50k XP per hour. The locations will be exactly the same as the lobster ones, only you're using a different fishing spot. A useful tip for fishing is to do the barbarian training from Otto, so you can fish without hands. This will even get you faster XP. The third fishing method will be sharks. This requires 76 fishing and a harpoon. The cash per hour will rate between 54 to 82k cash per hour, and this will make a total of 13 to 20k XP per hour. The price of sharks when this video was made were 495 GP each. This will make a total of 68k cash per hour. The prices could easily go up to 1.5k each, however, which would make a total of 200k cash per hour. So make sure you have an eye out for the prices. For the next fishing method, I'm showing monkfish. This requires 62 fishing, a small fishing net, and to do the swan song quest. You'll make about 140k cash per hour, and this will make 35k XP per hour. The location to fish these are in the Piscator's fishing colony, which you can go to by taking the fairy rings AKQ and then go north, the spirit kaya teleport and then go north, or go out south at the Grand Tree, walk west and then go all the way north. The prices of monkfish when this video was made are 348 GP each, which will make a total of 140k cash per hour. However, prices could go up to 600 GP each, which would make a total of 240k cash per hour. And for the last fishing method, I'm going to show you rocktails, which requires 90 fishing, a fishing rod and living minerals, which can be bought from the GE. The cash rate will between 170 to 190k cash per hour, which will make an XP rate of 37 to 40k XP per hour. The location will be in the Falador Mines, which you can enter from the Ice Mountain or from Falador East. After you go down, you go all the way west and you can start fishing at a rocktail spot. The price of rocktails when this video was made were 1791 GP each. And the minerals were 410 GP each, which would make a total of 160k cash per hour. Prices, however, could easily go up to 2.4k each, which would make a total of 230k cash per hour. So have an eye out for the prices. It's also possible to get minerals from the dead rock creatures that are laying around. Usually when people are slaying there, they'll just leave them there so you can mine them after a minute, which is free cash for you. The next skill is woodcutting, and I'm showing you yew trees, which requires 60 woodcutting, a rune or dragon hatchet, and you'll make between 90 to 115k cash per hour, which is around 200 logs, and additionally you'll get 30 to 40k XP per hour. The best locations to chop yew trees at are north of Feral Castle, which is free to play, northwest of Rimington, which is free to play also, west of Ketherby, which is members, and Gnome Stronghold, which is also members. And yeah, that's all there's to it. You chop the logs and you sell them in the GE, and it's free profit. For the second method, I'm showing you magic trees, which requires 75 woodcutting, a rune or dragon hatchet. You'll make between 108 to 135k cash per hour, which is around 90 logs, and the XP rate will between 20 to 25k XP per hour. The best places to chop magic trees at is at the Sorcerer's Tower, which is south of Sears Village, just west of Lelecha, the Tree Gnome Stronghold, east of the Ranging Guild, and the Magic Training Arena. Moving on to the farming skill, I'm showing you how to get herbs, which requires at least 31 farming, but the higher the better obviously. A spade, a rake, a seed dipper, and herb seeds. It will be between 100 to 350k cash per hour. That totally depends on your level, what type of herbs you're doing, and the prices at that moment. You'll get between 10 to 25k XP per hour, and the trips only take about 5 minutes. The 5 locations to farm these herbs at are at Canifis, Draenor Village, Ardi, Trollheim, and Catherby. I also have a special video just for farming herbs, and the link will be somewhere in the description and probably also on screen. So if you want to watch that later, you can just click the link. The next skill is magic, and I'm starting off with showing enchanting jewelry. This requires at least 27 magic plus the runes for it, and sapphire or emerald jewelry. You'll make between 200 and 250k cash per hour, which is around 950 casts per hour, and you'll get about 36k XP per hour. It's really easy to do. You simply buy cosmic runes and emerald rings, for example. You simply cast the level 2 enchant on them, and they'll turn into rings of dueling, which gets you XP, and you can sell the rings with a lot of profit. The 1k enchants plus the 1k rings cost me around 1,016k. After enchanting them, I could sell 1k rings of dueling for 1245k plus, which is over 230k profit for just 1k rings, which is 1 hour work. The same thing works with sapphire rings to rings of recoil. You'll make about 190k profit per 1k rings, and you'll get 17k magic XP. The same method can be used with diamond rings to rings of life. You'll make about 220k profit per 1k rings and almost 70k XP. Or dragon stones to rings of wealth, which is around 190k profit per 1k rings, and this will give you 78k XP. Next up for magic is enchanting bolts. This requires 57 magic, and you'll need unenchanted diamond bolts. You'll make between 200 and 450k cash per hour, and that's about 1 to 1.6k casts per hour. In addition to that, you'll get 70k XP. For example, you buy 10k diamond bolts unenchanted from the GE, and you'll need 2k law runes and 1k cosmic runes to enchant them. This would make a total of 7.8 mil altogether. You simply cast the enchant bolt spell, and you choose for diamond bolts, and then it automatically starts making bolts for you. It takes about 70 seconds per 300 bolts. This will make a total of 15k bolts per hour. As you can see, it's about 200k profit per 10k bolts plus 70k XP, and this should take about 45 minutes at the max if you're doing it quickly. The next method for magic is charging orbs. This requires 56 magic, unpowered orbs, and 3 cosmic runes per orb. You'll make between 400 and 550k per hour, which is about 600 charges per hour, and with that you'll make 40k magic XP. So for example, the amount you can do per hour is 600. This costs a total of 500k in supplies. And a quick check shows that 600 air orbs are worth over 1 million. And now I'm going to show you how to charge air orbs. You start in Edgeville, you take cosmic runes and unpowered orbs in your inventory. You stuff your BOB familiar up with air orbs, and you fill back up your inventory, and you go south out of Edgeville, down the ladder, all the way north, and then east to the gates, back north to the gates. You'll go through 4 wieldy levels, so be careful, you can be killed here. Keep going northwest till you find the ladder, go up the ladder and cast the charge air orb spell on this obelisk. It will charge the orbs in your inventory, and you'll make profit with that. A trip takes approximately 210 seconds, which should get you around 600 charges per hour. A bit more if you bring a yak, of course, but this is for the Terror Bird one. Either use a glory to teleport back to Edgeville, which is the fastest method, or you can use home teleport to Edgeville, which is a bit slower but doesn't require extra money. Next up for magic is humidify vials. This requires 68 magic, and to have the lunar magics, which requires the lunar diplomacy quest, empty vials, 1 astro runes per 27 vials, and you'll get between 180 to 220k cash per hour, which is around 500 inventories, and this will get you 35k magic XP. The method is quite straightforward. You simply need empty vials in your inventory and astral runes, and you'll be needing to wield a steam staff. All you have to do is fill your inventory with empty vials, cast the spell humidify, and it will fill up all the vials, and then replace those with new empty vials from your bank. I was making over 300 GP profit per inventory, and you can put the inventory really close to your bank, so it's really easy to take out all the vials and put your water filled vials back in. The next method is almost the same as using humidify on vials, only this time you need clay and 1 astral per 27 clay. This makes you between 400 and 600k profit, which is also around 500 inventories and also 35k magic XP. You simply use the same method, only this time you use clay, and the clay will turn into soft clay, and you can sell these with a lot of profit. As you can see, I was making about 1260 GP profit per inventory. It's possible to do 500 inventories per hour, which would make 630k profit per hour at this time of the video. It's possible that the items will not sell for mid price, so I'd assume 500 to 600k on average. The next skill is fletching, and I'm going to show you how to make bolts. This requires 54 fletching, an ability to make broad bolts, which requires 300 slayer points, feathers, and unfinished broad bolts. It's also possible to do mithril bolts, but these buy really slow. Only if you're willing to wait for a long time, then you can do mithril bolts. You'll make between 150 to 250k profit per hour, which is around 55k bolts. This will get you between 150 to 180k fletching XP. At the time of recording, the feathers bought for 15 GP each and the unfinished bolts for 52 GP each, which was a total of 67 GP, and you can sell them afterwards for 72 GP each, which is around 5 GP each profit. You can make up to 50k bolts per hour. This means every 1 GP extra you can get for each of them will get you 50k profit extra per hour. The next skill is thieving, and we're gonna pickpocket master farmers. This requires 38 thieving, but the higher level you are, the easier it will get. The cash rate will rate between 200 and 400k profit per hour. This kind of depends on luck, and the XP rate will be between 30 and 40k, and this depends on your level. The location is north of Ardi, which is almost next to the lodestone, and there's also one in Draenor village, but I prefer to do the one in Ardi. But cash wise it wouldn't really make a difference. The method is pretty straightforward. All you have to do is spam click the master farmer and you'll get seeds from him, and you have to look out for the most expensive seeds, for example snapdragon, renner seeds, and all other herb seeds, which are quite valuable and can make you a lot of profit. You can also bring an Ardi cloak, which boosts your thieving, along with gloves of silence and a magpie, which will all boost your thieving level. Moving on to mining, and we're gonna mine concentrated gold ore. This requires 80 mining and a pickaxe. You'll make between 200 and 230k profit per hour, which is 45 to 60k mining XP. The location is in the Felador mines, which you can enter from East Felador or from the Ice Mountain north of Felador. You simply go down by using the rope and then go all the way south till you find the concentrated gold ore spot. You can simply stand in the corner and keep mining, and you'll get in your inventory. After that you can simply bank them near the entrance where there is a deposit box. Next up is summoning. I'm going to show you the fruit bed method, which requires 69 summoning, a fruit fall scrolls, fruit bed pouches, and summoning potions. You make between 600 and 900k profit per hour, which is around 700 scrolls and 40 summoning potions per hour, and you'll make only 1400 XP in summoning. You simply buy fruit fall scrolls, fruit bed pouches, and summoning potions from the GE, and then you have to find a wide open spot close to a bank, so you can bank the fruit that you're getting from the fruit bed. I, for example, do it at Catherby, which is in front of the bank. All you have to do is run around to keep casting the fruit fall scroll from your summoning icon, and then the fruits will appear, and all you have to do is pick them up and bank the most valued ones. Usually the oranges and the papayas make the most profit, so you can bank these. The papayas should be around 1.5k each, and the oranges around 700 to 1k each. Also keep in mind that the fruit bat will also store up on fruit just by doing nothing, and you can use the store BOB button in your bank to store all these items that it's giving you also. So that's free extra profit. The next skill is Hunter, and I'm going to show you Red Chinchompas. This requires 63 Hunter, and the higher the better. You'll need box traps and a short bow with cheap arrows. You'll make between 200 and 300k profit per hour, which is around 300 to 450 gins, and you'll get up to 125k XP if you're a higher level. The location is north of Uglock, or northeast of mobilizing armies. The actual spot doesn't really matter as long as there's chins. Basically, all you have to do is put up your box traps and the chins will go in there. If they just run around and do nothing, you simply kill them, so they'll respawn close to your box and go in there really fast. Also, personally, I think it's useful if there's another guy training next to you, because he'll make the chins go in his traps and they'll respawn faster and closer to your boxes, so you'll get faster chins. The next method for a hunter is Grenwalls. This requires 77 hunter, box traps, 69 summoning and fruit bats plus footfall scrolls. You'll make between 900 to 1200k profit per hour, which is around 1k spikes per hour, and the XP is around 75k hunter. You need to have completed the quest Underground Pass, and it's also useful to have the Regicide quest done. You can get here through Lelecha, which requires the Mornings End Part 1 quest, but it's easier to use the charter ship all the way west to RuneScape to the Elven thingy, and then find your way north till you get to the bridge. This method looks quite difficult, but it's quite simple actually. All you have to do is put up your box traps and fill them with papayas, and once you catch something, it will always be a palya, which you can pick up, and then put those in the trap, and you can use those as bait to catch Grenwalls, and the Grenwalls will give you a lot of profit. The next and final skill is runecrafting, and we're gonna make double astral runes. This requires 80 runecrafting, pure essence and lunar diplomacy quest. You'll make between 600 and 750k profit per hour, which is around 5 to 6k astrals per hour, and this will get you 25k runecrafting XP. In your inventory, you'll need all the pouches you have, law runes and Terrorbird scrolls, and the rest will be pure essence. You simply start at the lunar bank, you go outside the city all the way south, and you keep running till you get through the Suka. These can cause you some damage, but it won't be that much. You end up at the astral altar. All you have to do is runecraft your astrals here, and empty your pouches, runecraft again, and then teleport back to the bank. You make approximately 60 laps per hour, which is around 12k profit per lap, which is a total of 732k profit per hour at the moment. You also need to be wearing a earth staff or anything that gives you earth runes, and you can teleport back to the bank. You store your astral runes, you fill back up your pouches with new pure essence, and you repeat the process. Next up for the runecrafting is double nature runes. This requires 91 runecrafting, also pure essence, and you'll need a grog pouch. The cash per hour is between 500 and 700k profit per hour, which is around 5 to 6k nature runes, and you'll make around 25k XP. I personally start off at the Tsar, and I use the Tokkel Zo ring to teleport back to the Tsar. You can also start off at Castle Wars and use dueling rings to teleport back there, or you can use the Ring of Kinship and teleport back to Demonheim, only that's really slow. The best way to do this is by having all the three largest pouches you have in your inventory, along with all the pure essence you can get. You use your grog to teleport to Karamja, you run all the way east to the altar, and you enter it, runecraft your essence to nature runes, empty all your pouches, runecraft again, teleport to your bank with any ring you're using, or a glory to Edgefill, store your nature runes, fill back up your pouches, and use your grog again to teleport to Karamja. I'm just going to show you another lap. It's also useful to run around the north side of the trees, because it's just a little bit faster. At the time of the video, the pure essence was 85 GP each, and two nature runes together were 250 GP each, which is around 165 GP profit per runes, and you can make up to 3k essence per hour, which is around 500k profit per hour, but it could easily go up, so have an eye out for the prices. Alright guys, thanks for watching. If you want to see part 2 or part 3, they'll probably be on screen when they're uploaded, and you can just click them and they'll redirect you to the new video. Please leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. I put a lot of time and effort in it. And obviously I'm going to do the same for the other two money making methods that I'm remaking. Also, if you thought the methods were going too fast, I could put the skills separately on my secondary channel Bomb Block HQ and put them in more detail. But let me know in the comments what you think about that. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon. Peace! Like a boss.